No, Mom, I gotta go. Steve Schirripa is coming over. Yes, the guy from The Sopranos. He wrote this book. It's about raising two girls.
Yes, I have two girls. That's why I thought it would be good to have him over.
Mommy, I need a pretty picture.
Oh my God. Mom, I really have to go. Hi.
Hey, how are you?
Thank you for coming. I'm Ilana. One second.
So
hello?
You live here.
I do, yeah. One second. Hi, Mom. It's my mother. She doesn't believe. Can you say hello? Yes. Hold on.
How are you, baby? Yeah, I'm here with Ilana. She's safe. Don't worry. I didn't know I was coming to her living room, but it's all good.
All right, you got that? Okay, thank you. Yes. Okay, so Mazzy, she set up a little thing for you in the green room, a little snack. So we just need to set up.
The green room? We're in your apartment. Hiya, I'm Steve.
Can
I sit there? Okay, hi. Nice to meet you. Shake my hand? Oh, that's a good shake.
Do you want a cookie?
Wow. So how's everything going?
Fine.
Good? Your mom's okay? Do we have any tea? Espresso? You have any Sambuca?
Hi, everyone. Today we're talking to Steve Schirripa, who is the author of Big Daddy's Rules, Raising Daughters is Tougher Than I Look. We have a dad in this household that could probably use a few pointers. So please help me welcome Steve Schirripa.
This is just like the first time I did the Tonight Show.
It's the same
very
thing. Similar.
Very nice.
Have
hey.
A seat.
You doing all right? Good to see you again.
So what made you write the book?
Well, I wrote the book kind of as a love letter to my daughters, you know. My daughters are 21 and 17, and I yell a lot, and I scream a lot, and I want to let them know how I really feel, you know. And I have some opinions, a lot of opinions, and I thought I should get it out there and throw my hat in the ring.
So what's the biggest piece of advice you could give to me raising two girls?
Well, because I said so, are the four greatest words in the English language. I mean, I say it constantly. They're always questioning you. Why not? Why can't I do this? So. This is the same things we did as we were a kid.
Sometimes I think, you know, part of it is the parent and then part of it is the kid. Like, sometimes I think kids, like, some kids are better at listening than others. Or do you think it's all the parent?
I find it hard to believe that this kid is going to be impossible to control.
Right.
Unless, you know, you don't want them to control, you know?
Right. You want nice warm? We can get you nice warmy milky. No. She wants milk.
Today, you have some over there?
You want to get it for me?
Yeah. And the zippy cup. No more bottle? You're a big girl, right?
Right? No bottle.
Is that good?
How much does lying play into parenting?
Well, I think you have to lie somewhat. Mm-hmm. I mean, you know,
think about what?
Like, a perfect example is, listen, I spoke to your teacher. She told me that you're screwing up at school, blah, blah, blah.
Right.
You didn't speak to the teacher. Right. I think it's okay to lie at things like that.
I tell her it's like, it's the law that she has to hold my hand when we cross the street.
There you go. A few years ago, me and my wife went on to San Francisco. My daughter was 17. We left them alone. Never in a million years would I have thought she had a party. We come home, my wife sees the footprints all over the wood floors.
It's okay, sweetie.
I've got on camera, I've got every kid that was here, write it down. I'm gonna call their parents. She gave it right up. I never told.
So she didn't try to deny
it? I didn't have to get people on camera, I lied, you know. She gave it right up.
To keep them in line.
Yeah, you know, but it used to be when we were kids, I'm going to tell the policeman. That's why people are afraid of cops.
Right.
All the mothers and fathers said, we're going to tell the policeman. He's going to arrest you if you don't hold my hand, right?
Right.
Do you cook?
Not really. My husband's more of the cook.
He cooks.
I figured you could kind of guide us through some pizza making.
Stereotype.
Sorry.
I'm Italian, so I know how to make pizza. Oh, let's put a little dough. A little flour. Okay. Flour on the bottom.
All right.
I think that's how
we... I need some flour.
Okay, we need some flour.
Yeah, you need a little flour.
Okay.
That's gonna be fun. Oh, boy, you don't have a shot. It's a good thing you're a good writer, because you have no idea.
No, I'm rolling it.
You're a nice Jewish girl making pizza.
Mine's already ripping.
No. Phil will fix it. You can fix it. You don't have to sew it. Put it back together.
Right,
pinch
like
it.
This?
There you go.
Okay. That's okay if it's dripping. You know what you do? When you put it on, look. You go like this, and then you can spread it around like this.
Look at that.
I've watched that in the pizza parlor.
That is very good. Macaroni's not bad.
Are you just eating it plain now?
Yeah.
Okay. So now, is there one little piece of advice that you could give me for now that will help me as they get older?
It's okay to say stop it. No, their self-esteem isn't going to suffer. Uh-huh. Believe me. Don't listen to the psychiatrist. Listen to Uncle Steve. I'm telling you.
Say no.
And learn how to make pizza.
I think I did a pretty good job.
It looks good. It looks good. Mine is a little lopsided, but I think we did all right. You can't screw up pizza. Mike, listen to me. I'm not a genius, Mike, but I know a little about this stuff. I mean, I'm not Dr. Phil, but, you know, I have my own opinion. The most important thing in the whole book, you're their father, you're not their friend, but you're the best friend they're ever going to have because no one's going to love them as much as you for the rest of their life. So I think you need to read the book. There's some good stuff in there, and that way your wife will get off your back.